Okay, so I should have ordered. I should have recorded this ages ago, but this I got on sale. Its original price would be around £80. I got it 80 or 90. I got it for $49.99, and that's not even including my. I think at the time I wasn't platinum yet, so my gold Club Inspire discount, which was like 15%. Plus there was another. The monthly discount, like I think it was OCT for October 10th, so like another 10% off. So lovely, jubbly. And I got a glitter glue, glittering motion, part of the mermaid set for $2.99. That was on sale. But saying that, when they put this in the box, it was just like, you know, just a tiny bit bigger than this. They just, because there was an outer box, they just shove this in here like this. You know how like how boxes have like a fold there and fold there? They shoved it in between one, like the first one, so when I opened it, it just rolled out. But, like, since they just shoved it in there, it was like really like squish and like and burst. So I took pictures and sent that to them, and then they gave me a replacement. So, keep that on the side, but I'll basically I'll show that in the replacement video, which I think I'll put it after this one on the same day, because like from a previous order I needed a replacement for two ink pads and for them to actually send me one, because I forgot to put that in the order. So this, as you probably saw by this, is the template library. So excited. I had to wait for a good time to get this, and it's a good thing I waited, because then I would have bought it on sale if I didn't wait. But, oh, what was I going to say? yeah, what was I going to say? Yes, so obviously templates, so this way I won't have to think about, you know, what size of card I need to do and like to measure it from like the card blanks, because, you know, like card blank is in A4 sheet of card, because now I don't need to think about it, it's just in the template. Oh, it looks lovely. And this is the violet, which is the first one. Comes with a block. Make a stand. So I guess, oops, it would be. Is this one? Well, it was this one. Like that. Very nice. No, it goes the other way because the title's in the front. Proper way. So that's dividers. It says dividers on the envelope. Welcome to the template library, where you'll find templates galore with step-by-step instructions to create projects aplenty. Don't forget, we also have video guides to demonstrate how to use each template. Go to that website for that. They come with this, which is very nice. dividers first so I can get this out of the way. I'm guessing this goes over here. Like that. Then this goes up here. Is that it, or is it the other way around? I mean, I can easily change it. Is it that way or the other way? I think it's the other way, actually. Right? Or is it the other way? It's like... supposed to be. Because I think it's this way, because it can go all the way down. Am I even showing you on this thing? I was filling with the dividers. See, I think the bigger one goes up here. Not too sure, but hey, okay. So we have the recipe cards and metal die. This would go, would slip in here, I believe. I mean, just put it on here to begin with? I don't know. Since like, I have no idea what this is. I'll have to move some stuff off my desk to put this there instead. Because they won't fit in the shelf either, I believe. Well, here are the dies it comes with. I'll have to take it off this stickiness, so it'll be annoying. But, very lovely frames. Really, three circles, an oval, three elongated ovals like that, like a frame thing, three other frames here, no frames really, but that kind of shape, and we've got some scallop shapes here, kind of a star-ish one right here, and a heart. Very lovely. Comes with its little pocket. Just, well, trying to put this on, and this thing kind of cracked. See? So, it's unnecessarily fiddly. So, I'm trying to put it in, but it's not going in. Anyway, forget that for now. What recipes are in here? Let's read it out, shall we? We got 30. Milk carton gift box. Oh, it's so boring just reading it out from there, isn't it? I'm just gonna put this. To show you. So, you light first. Like, so in total, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, I think they're doing these two next because they just finished and sold out of the yellow lickety split. And, so they're starting over again after they release these two, orange and red, I think. There's violet, it's gonna be purple, blue, green, yellow. Oh yeah, to be honest, it does not look like violet. Looks more like pink, but anyway. We've got milk carton gift box. A step rocker card. Octagon shutters. Interlocking squares. Double diamond fan fold. Left stepper. double stuffer. Strawberry gift box. Three stuff. Diamond fold. Concertina surprise box. Tiny gift box and pocket. Arrow fold. Dutch fold hook, tri-fold shell, steered plates, and foodie. That's cool. Envelope with letter for 3x6 cards. Envelope liner and pocket for 4x4. Bonbon gift box. Handbag card with gift card holder. Enclosed stepper. Zigzag cascade card. Corner fold easel card. Two sizes of pop-up diamond cards. Envelope to fit a 4x6 card and a small heart envelope. Envelope of 5x7 and small pocket. Dimensional envelope for 6x4. And envelope for 6x6 and 3x3. Nice. So he says you put them in here. So very snazzy. And if you want to take out the recipe, let's say this one. All you need to do is take it out. Paper should not be as flimsy like that, though. Look at that. Huh. Did I not take it out properly or something? And that's what it showed on the thing. Not bad, but I guess I probably wouldn't want to take it out often though. It's kind of cardboard, not very sturdy as probably the plastic or whatever the templates are made out of. So probably wouldn't really do that much at all. And then it says you can rip them out and put them back in. It's not very, I mean, it is thick card, but it didn't seem to be very good. But anyway. Sturdy, I think. Yes. So, like, this is a milk carton gift box. Box base needs a sheet of 8.5 by 11, which is basically an A4 sheet of paper. And embellishments needs the same. And it says you can make a card. That is our box of 6.9 by 10.2 inches. So, like, obviously you cut it out on the thing, so I don't think it needs to specify. But it's got, it specifies where all the score lines are. And it specifies that these are the embellishments. But yeah. No, I'm gonna put it back in. Oh. There you go. So, like, shows what's in that layer as well. Shows which is a cut line. Alternative mats and layers down here. So I can see you just use, oh, it shows which is mountain and valley fold. It's a left step card. Shall we do that? It seems simple enough, right? To 7 by 5. Come on. Doing the corners, so I'm going to cut that. Okay, we just need a rough thing, right? Big enough. Thank you. What else do I have to do? It's not the best. Thicker ruler than this. Yes, I got this from Christmas Cracker. But let's see. So then. Use a scoreboard and spin to score along the lines.
Thank you.
I guess that's how it's supposed to be. Fold and burnish all his coins. Fold his alternate mountain valley folds. Use a template to draw your chosen mat and mats and cutout. And mat card to decorate. Interesting. I guess that's how it's supposed to look. Let's do that on the floor too. Yeah, that's about right. About right size. A cut off. It's about right size of that one. My two of those ones and cut off of that one will fit. Lovely. I don't need another. Well, I do need another one for that layer, but. Thank you. Wait, this one is supposed to go on the bottom. I should have found one. Oh. So I'm getting more precision scissors to cut that properly. No, it should have all been punched out. Anyway. What should I get? So these are the layers to go for those two, that one, and this one. I'm not really sure what kind of color I'm going to get from the color. Well, for now, I'm going to just put all these things on the thing. Put this away. I'm technically, this is coffee paper, so I probably should have used the letter over there, but hey, this is more of an experiment. Then, probably, not sure what I'll do with this. The sides and the sides. Let's have a look. See? There's like, I don't know if you can actually see. There is a magnet, like right here. See? That's why it holds up when I lift it up by there. Alright, okay, so. Let's guessing it's spaced that way. Obviously, it won't fit once I do it the other way. Okay, this is fine. I don't think it would really. I mean, it might. I wonder if we do it that way. Oh, we'll see. Is that just a spare? Is that a spare, or do they... just one for each color. You don't really need one at the very end, do you? I guess I'll keep this one as well. Unless it goes right at the end. I'll just stick it there right now. Adjust them as I go, and I get the next one. Alright, that's great. So, I guess I'll leave it there, unless I want to do something with the other thing. To be honest, I don't know where to put these. Experiment with something. Either. Use that as a stencil and just go around. Let's try that first, shall we? These are the best ones for sure. I forgot to put the record back on, but decided to do Joe's beer and some brown. Do the manger and brown as well. I guess I do have some yellow and orange-ish, goldy kind of yellow as like part of the halo bits on there. And of course, Mary. Is in blue. I can't remember where. I mean, it's mainly her head thing. dress, I guess. That's blue, but anyway. And I also colored the star in. So I figured I'd just paste it on there. And then put those on the steps. For instance, Joseph will go right here. Mary will go here. And the Jesus will go right in the middle. Or I guess I could put this here. Put those there and put a Merry Christmas down there. This is odd. Because obviously these would be going there, there, and there. Some stuff on that. Thank you for watching. Let's start for more. Ring the bell for notifications. Over and out.